Welcome back to Life Literature. Today, I have in store for you a brand new lesson, a lesson based on the literary devices. I know you are thorough with these literary devices by now. But anyway, it will come in handy for you to brush up your knowledge and also to remember what you have already learned about this study of literature. And I'm quite concerned about the beginners also. The beginners will also find this lesson really important for them. So let's get started. What are literary devices? Literary devices is a term used by so many people in so many ways. Some people call them as poetic techniques. In some books, we find the term literary techniques. And in some other areas, we find the term figurative language. Whatever the term is, the meaning that underlies these terms is the same. They mean the literary devices or the poetic techniques which are used to beautify the language you use in your writing and also help you to convey what you mean effectively to the readers. The writer's basic need is to convey himself or herself to the reader effectively and beautifully so that the reader will be able to feel you, feel the writer as well. So let's get started with our study. I'm going to explain these devices through some of the songs that I have selected for you. I have selected some of the modern hits as well as some of the old golden hits as well. So let's go to the first song. The first song is a breezy disco pop by the world-renowned Korean pop group BTS. I know you'll love this. The song is named as Dynamite. I know you have listened to this song by now quite a lot of times. But anyway, this time you are going to listen to this song and you are going to watch this video, but with a new intention, not with the intention that you had earlier. Not just for enjoyment, you are going to learn something from it as well. Set the night light. Shoes on, get up in the morning, cup of milk, let's rock and roll. Kink out, kick the drum, rolling on like a rolling stone. Sing song when I'm walking home, jump up to the top of LeBron. Ding dong, call me on my phone, nice tea and I'll get my ping pong. This is dead heavy, can't hear the bass, boom, I'm ready. Life's sweet as honey, yeah, this beach chain like money. Yes, now we'll go to the techniques that we are going to find from it. First, I'm going to talk about the tone of the song. What do you think is the tone of the song? But anyway, I have to tell you what tone is. Isn't that so? So tone is the style, or you can call it the rhythm, which introduces the mood of the singer, or the mood of the composer, or the mood of the writer. So what sort of a mood are they in, the singers? They are in a quite a happy mood. So the tone of this song is a happy tone, a merry tone. Did you understand that happiness of the singers? The happiness of the singers comes through the words of the song. So these are the words that gives you a happy feeling while you listen to the song. I'm in the stars tonight, the singers say. What do you mean by I'm in the stars tonight? That means I feel I'm in heaven. I feel that I'm in heaven. And they say, watch me bring the fire. So they ask the audience to watch them. They are bringing fire to the audience. How can they bring fire to the audience? Because they are going to enjoy. And they are going to deliver their rapture, deliver their merriment to the audience as well, as if you are kindling fire in you, and set the night alight. By doing so, they are going to set the night alight. How are you going to light up the night to brighten the dark night? Night is, of course, a dark period of the day, and you are going to lighten up the darkness of the night through the song. So the tone of the song is quite a happy tone, quite a merry tone. So that's about the tone. The second device I'm going to introduce to you through this song is alliteration. Alliteration is a sound device. It is a technique that you produce through sound of the words. So this sound device can be identified as the close repetition of consonant sounds. What are consonant sounds? Consonant sounds are the sounds that produce that are being produced by the consonant letters. What are the consonant letters? Consonant letters are the letters except the vowels. How many vowels are there in English language? There are only 5 vowels. So then other than the 5 vowels, all the other 21 letters are consonant letters. So the sounds produced by these consonant letters are called consonant sounds. So if you hear consonant sounds repeated closely in a line, you call it alliteration. So here in this song, at regular intervals, we meet alliteration. For example, rock and roll, rock and roll. What is the closely knitted sounds? R, r, r in rock and r in roll. Then you have talk the talk, t, t, and you have King Kong kick. Thrice the sound k is repeated. King Kong kick, k, k, k. And then you have another sound, buzz, boom, b, b. So all these sounds are r, t, k, b. All these sounds are consonant sounds. And when these consonant sounds are repeatedly heard in a line very closely, you call that alliteration. So that is a very nice sound effect that we hear through this song. The third device I am going to show you in this song is a device called simile. Simile is one of the mostly used and mostly seen devices we very constantly come across in writings. Simile is a comparison of one thing with another. It is introduced by as or like. Simile is a comparison of one thing with another, and it is very easy to find out a simile because always a simile is introduced by either the word as or the word like. So in this song, where do you find similes? There's something like this. Life is sweet as honey. So sweet as honey is the simile used here. So here, life is compared to honey. So life is sweet as honey means, what do you think is the effect of it? It is so sweet. It is something so very tasty. You can be really happy with life. There's nothing wrong with your life. You are fully contented. You are completely happy. So it is an optimistic view of life. Life is sweet as honey. Another one, the beat charging like money. The beat of the song, the singers say they charging like money. like money. So do you know the rattling sound of money? So the beat of the song is something like the rattling sound of money. So it gives you the idea of a light beat. It gives to you the idea of a merry beat, a happy beat. Another example, light it up like dynamite. So what is being compared here? The sound of the song, the effect of the song, it's like dynamite. It is like an explosion. It's a huge sound. So it creates a massive effect, just like the song Dynamite, how it had hit the audience in 2020. Okay, right. Now we'll go to the second song I have selected for you. It is one of the popular hits of 1970s by a very popular singer of that time called John Denver. You can call it as a folk rock as well, a country rock. It's something like a rock song, but it is to the side of the country rock of timeless genre. It is a country rock of timeless genre, because its effects are still seen here by the year 2020 also. I'm sure you are going to enjoy this song very well. Country Roads, Take Me Home.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home.
Unveils the nostalgia of an American over his native state, West Virginia. It creates the very picture of the figurative device called personification. Here, as you listen to this song, you might have heard the singer's yearning to go back home. Where do you think is his home? His home is in the state of West Virginia in America. America is a huge country with so many states, so many different states. So this singer is a native of West Virginia. So he's yearning to go back home from somewhere else. So to convey his yearning, to convey his desire, he has used the poetic technique called personification. What is personification? A thing, an idea, or an animal is given human qualities. Or else we can say non-human objects are given ability to act like humans. So that is called personification. Here, the singer tells, the singer requests from the country roads. He requests from the country roads, take me home. So the roads are given life. The roads are treated as a person. The roads are treated as humans. Take me home. I am not able to go back to my native place. So I'm requesting, take me home, dear country roads. And also he says, mountain mama. Mountain mama means he considers the mountains of the West Virginia, his native land, as a mother. So by using that word mother, he conveys his love, his respect regarding the scenic beauty of his hometown, home village. And also he says, all my memories gathered round her. So here the state West Virginia is called as her by the female pronoun, the feminine pronoun her. So there he is personifying the entire state of West Virginia, giving life to it and considering it as a human being. And also he says, I hear her voice, the sound of the country, the invitation of the country for him to come back home. He can hear, and he uses the sound, he calls the sound as her voice. And also he says, in the morning hour, she calls me. Whenever he gets up in the morning, he hears the sound of her. Her means the motherly West Virginia. And also, another technique he uses here, that is called nostalgia. Nostalgia is the feeling of homesickness. It is a strong desire for the past. If you want so much to cherish the memories of the past, maybe the happy memories, maybe the sad memories, whatever it is, if you want to cherish, if you want to live back through those memories, you call it nostalgia. So this is the feeling of homesickness that we find here in this song. So he says, teardrop in my eye. Why teardrops are there in his eye? Because he is away from his mother. He is away from his motherly state, that is West Virginia. And he says, the radio reminds me. Whenever he listens to the radio reminds him of his native land, of my home far away. His home is there, far away from him. So he's yearning back to go there. I should have been home yesterday, he says. I should have been home yesterday, the repetition, he repeats it twice. Why? This decision he should have taken earlier. He had lingered much time here in another place other than going to his home place. So those are the two devices I have forwarded to you to this song. The next device I am going to forward to you is a very important and a very nice device called symbolism. Symbolism is the use of symbols to signify the ideas and qualities of a person, thing, or a notion. Notion means an idea. they are different from their literal sense. They are different from their normal sense. Literal sense means the normal sense. For example, a very common symbol that we all know, the dove, is the symbol of peace. So, dove is a bird, peace is an idea, a notion. These two things are compared and they convey a very different meaning, not the normal meaning of the word dove. Right? So, in the same way, here in the song I have selected for you, there is a very beautiful, romantic and patriotic symbol. This song comes to you as Edelweiss. It is a short but extremely sweet song of the late 1950s. Okay, we'll listen to it now. Edelweiss is a small white flower found in the Austrian Alps more than 10,000 feet above the sea level. Quite a higher elevation. During the Second World War, German troops would travel high up in the Alps mountain just to pick a small flower. Why? To prove their heroism. They had wanted to tell the others they had been so heroic and they had climbed up such heights of the mountain just to pick this small, tiny, beautiful white flower. And also, not only to prove heroism, so many young men who wanted to convey their love to their brides, they had also done this. They had also climbed such great heights to pick this tiny flower and to present the flower to the bride as a token of their true love, to prove their love. Therefore, it is a symbol of love and heroism, symbol of love and bravery. This song is sung in the film Sound of Music of 1959 fame to highlight the patriotism of the captain George Ludwig von Trapp when he was about to leave his motherland with his family against the Nazis' effort to make him join the navy of the Nazis of Germany. You might have watched this film. It had one time become so very famous even in Sri Lanka. So, that is the story behind this song. Here the singer addresses the flower, "Every morning you greet me," and wishes for it, "May you bloom and grow forever." It is a patriotic wish, "Bless my homeland forever." So, there the patriotism of this naval officer is very well conveyed to the people of the nation using this beautiful song, symbolically taken this beautiful white flower as the symbol of love and patriotism. Okay, let's go to our final song. It is a hit of 1970s once again, "Top of the World" by Carpenters. Carpenters were an American duo, sister and brother, called Karen and Richard Carpenters. It is a bright and happy song, and it is full of romantic celebration. Okay, let's go for it now.
Such a feeling's coming over me. There is wonder in most everything I see. Not a cloud in the sky, got the sun in my eyes, and I won't be surprised if it's a dream. Everything I want the world to be is now coming true.
Her happy tone is expressed through beautiful images taken from nature. Not a cloud in the sky, got the sun in my eyes. So here, I'm going to introduce you to another new device that is called metaphor. Metaphor is an indirect comparison. It is an indirect comparison, not like the simile that we have discussed earlier. It is an indirect comparison. Here we say something is something else. Did you understand that? Here we say something is something else. For example, here the singer says, "Got the sun in my eyes." So here maybe the sun is her lover. Sun is a natural object, but here the singer uses that word, or the composer uses that natural image to identify the lover of the singer. So the sun is indirectly compared to the lover. So such a thing is called as a metaphor. And then she says, "You are the nearest thing to heaven that I've seen." Once again, it's a metaphor. You are the nearest thing to heaven. That means you are the God. So who is this God? God is the lover. So here, the lover is once again compared to a divine figure, a God-like image. So once again, another metaphor is used. And the next technique that I'm going to present to you is hyperbole through this poem. Hyperbole. What's hyperbole? Hyperbole can also be called as exaggeration. exaggeration is use of clear, deliberate descriptions which is highly unlikely in real life. So these things can, you cannot believe such things happen in real life. Such things are called exaggeration. So they are highly unlikely in real life, in reality, but they are used to express strong feelings, sometimes to express strong likings, sometimes to express strong hatred, likewise. And here, of course, hyperbole is used to express the singer's extreme happiness over the love that she had cherished in her heart. The singer says, "I'm on the top of the world looking down on creation. Your love put me on the top of the world." So how has she climbed to the top of the world? Through the love of her lover. Her celebration of love is such that she feels that she has reached the top of the world and looking down on the other creations of the world. She had cherished in her heart this love so much, and she celebrates her love saying that your love put me on the top of the world. So that is the exaggeration that she is creating. That is the hyperbole that she is creating here, just to show us, just to tell us how much has she turned herself into a happy figure, to a happy person through this love. So by watching these songs, I hope that you have learned a number of devices. Actually, 8 devices at a stretch. So I will try to remind you of these devices: tone, alliteration, simile, personification, nostalgia, symbolism, metaphor, and hyperbole. So these are not all. There are so many other devices, other poetic techniques which enhance the writings of the literary works. We'll try to learn them gradually in another video clip. And until such time, goodbye.